Hey, I'm Josh. I'm going to spend the next few minutes walking through step-by-step how to connect your Bubble database with Google Sheets without the need for any more subscriptions or middleware. It's connecting Bubble directly with Google Sheets, so you can go ahead and close that tab with Zapier open right away. I promise you it'll be super easy. In fact, it's only a few steps that are easy to follow along at home and only take a few minutes. But to do this, I'm going to share my screen with you now and we'll go from there. All right, let's get started. So there are a few components that we need to go through. The first is this Google Sheet here. Now, it doesn't look like much. It's two tabs with just a couple of cells of data on them. Although sitting in the background is a script, and that script is the thing that connects through to Bubble's database and pulls in all of the data from the API. So that's sitting in App Script, if anybody's familiar with that. But don't worry, we'll go through that in just a moment. I've also got my Bubble editor open. I've also got the Bubble Data API documentation, which I'll just briefly touch on, and I'll show you how you can get a hold of this particular sheet. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is go into our Bubble editor and just switch on the Data API. So I think it's worth noting that you do need to be on a paid plan to be able to access the Data API. So for this particular test app, I'm on the personal plan, which is $29 a month, and that provides me with access to the Data API. What I need to do is go ahead and switch that on. I will get a privacy warning, which I do need to just confirm that I understand that I'm exposing my database. There is authentication involved, but you are opening up the fortress slightly. All right, so in this demo app, I have a few different tables that I can connect to. So for this case, I'm just going to open up the user table. So it is worthwhile just limiting access to the Data API to those particular tables that you do want to access. Otherwise, you're potentially exposing more information than you would need to. The next thing we need to do is generate an API token. So we can just click on this here, and we can name this something memorable. So let's call this Google Sheets so we know what it is. And that's really all we need to do from the Bubble side of things. There is a potentially more advanced implementation where you're using the backend workflows and connecting to those particularly, but they operate a lot like the Data API. So I won't touch on that now, because I think once you understand how to connect to the Data API, it does become quite clear how you can connect through to those backend workflows if that's something that you work with. Okay. So coming over to the Google Sheets here. Now what we need to do is we need to copy and paste in our Data API root URL, which is everything that's here. Now do note that I'm on the development version here, so I do have version test. If I wanted to connect to my production database, I would just need to remove that. Okay, and I can copy that in there. Now I come back here and I can copy my private key and I can paste that in here. And then I also need to specify the table name. So I'll just jump back here. You can see that it's user. So I'm just going to, in lowercase, just type in user. Now, what I do in the background is actually stitch all of this together in the right format for the script to be able to make the API call to Bubble. All right, now if I come back over here, I can see that I've got my two records coming through into this particular table here. And I can click refresh data if I do want to refresh that up to the moment. So this is an important thing to note here is that it is asking me for authorization. So once you start to click on things, you will notice a few pop-ups asking for authorization. And this is just giving this spreadsheet access to the script that sits in the background. So that will open up. So open up on my other screen and I will just connect through to that. Now, if we wanted to have this refresh automatically in the background for us on a recurring schedule, what we can do is we can come up here to the extensions and we can click on App Script. And this will take us into the App Script editor. And there's a lot of code here. You don't need to touch any of that. That is the good news. What we can do is we can come over here to the triggers. We can click on that. And I'll just move myself out of the way and we can click Add Trigger. Now, there are a bunch of different functions that come up, but the one that we want to use in this case is Trigger Auto Refresh. And we can put that on time driven. So there are different ways that you can trigger the script to run. In this case, we'll just do it on a very simple time driven exercise. And we'll do that, say, once an hour. And over here, it'll automatically be set to send me an email every day if there's any issues with the script. But if everything's fine, then I won't hear anything. Okay, I can click save. And that's it. So that is now going to refresh for me on an hourly basis and pull in the fresh data for me. So if you now wanted to bring in multiple tables of information at the same time, you could go through and duplicate this tab here, which is source data. And the data is actually getting pulled in. So that information that we put on the settings tab is getting pulled into this particular formula here, which calls the function that sits in the background. So I won't go through this in a lot of detail because it is core Google Sheets Excel knowledge. I would expect that you probably know what's going on here, but if you do need any help, just put a comment down below and I'll do my best to help you out with that. Okay, so this is all that you do need to do. I think it is worthwhile just pointing out that the Bubble Data API documentation is worth reading. It's only a couple of pages, but this just gives you a good understanding about what the structure of that URL needs to be. It gives you information about how you can pull in just parts of a table or particular records. In this particular case, we don't have the ability to push changes back to Bubble, so it is just pulling one way, but it does allow you to, and if we come down right to the bottom here, you can look at how you can search for records. So if you've got 10 or 20,000 records in a table, you may not want to pull all of that down in one go because it's a lot of information and it would take some time. So you may want to limit your query. Now, this is an interesting one, pagination. So the Bubble Data API only allows you to pull down 100 items at any one time. And if you're using the workflows, I think it's limited to something like 50. So in the script, what it actually does is it will keep repeating in a loop until there are no more items to pull down. So if you've got 1,000 items in your table, it will actually make 10 calls through to Bubble and it will pull down all of those records and put those into the sheet for you. And here's just a little bit more information in terms of the search constraints. Okay, so to get access to that Google Sheet, there are a couple of ways that you can do it. So there is an open source project, which is called Import JSON, which you can use. And this has given me a lot of inspiration to prepare this particular sheet. However, it doesn't deal with the pagination issue. So what I have done is I've made available this project, which I've built for myself, for you to download and replicate. I do ask for a small payment, but you can use this as much as you like. It's a one-off cost. You can use it for an unlimited number of projects, pull down an unlimited amount of information. There are no restrictions to it once you have your copy of this spreadsheet. So I'll provide a link to this down in the description. All right. And if you do have any questions, I'd love to hear from you. Thank you so much.